We experience rain composed of liquid water. Have you ever imagined that the sky can rain something other than water? No? Okay. On Titan, it rains liquid methane. And on Neptune, Jupiter, Saturn, and Uranus, it rains solid diamonds. On Earth, heat from the sun turns water from plants, oceans, lakes, and rivers into water vapors, which disappears into the air. And there, it cools down and forms tiny water droplets through a process called condensation. These tiny droplets then turn into clouds. When the water droplets get too large and heavy, they fall as rain under gravity. Now, astronomers think that it rains diamonds on Neptune, Jupiter, Saturn, and probably Uranus. So how is it possible? You're watching Deep Red Zone, and here we are talking about diamond rain on Neptune, Jupiter, Saturn, and probably Uranus, taking anywhere in between 1 and 3.3 billion years to form. Diamonds are one of the most rare and coveted gemstones in our society. They have been sold for up to millions of dollars depending on quality. Diamonds may be very rare on Earth, but astronomers believe that they are very common in the universe. In our atmosphere, there is carbon dioxide, oxygen, nitrogen, and some other gases. But on Jupiter, Neptune, and probably Uranus, there is methane. The huge thunderstorms turn this methane present in their atmosphere into soot, or unburned carbon particles. As clouds of black carbon is running down on the planet, they clump together and form graphite. It has been postulated that very high temperatures and pressures act upon it. These conditions overcome the energy of bonds between the carbon and hydrogen, leading the carbon atoms to rearrange, thus forming the diamonds. But before you try to get the next shuttle out there, you should know that due to the extremely hot core of all these planets, the diamonds do not stay in solid form too long. They melt when they get closer to the planet's surface, and are most likely transformed into other materials. Now, researchers have recreated the effects here on Earth. Scientists created two shockwaves in polystyrene plastic, using the matter in extreme conditions instrument at the SLAC National Accelerator Laboratory to generate a huge amount of heat. But the exact process has never been observed in experiments on Earth before now. Some previous experiments failed because the pressures and temperatures inside the atmosphere of this planet cannot be created in the lab for long. And without the ability to record data in the speed afforded by the LCLS, the linear coherent light source. But what will happen if it rained diamonds on Earth? Well, that's another episode of Deep Red Zone. So guys, what do you think about this? If you have any questions or suggestions, comment down below the video. Thanks for watching, subscribe to this channel if you haven't already, and also press the bell icon to get the notifications of new episodes.